Hello, my lovely Aquarius. This is going to be your December reading, your magical December reading, because the magical things are going to happen for you and you're going to be ready for 2020. So I hope that you guys are ready for 2020. We are going to go through some predictions for you for December in this reading as well. Remember, it's general, so always take what resonates, leave the rest. This is for female, this is for males. This is not only about love, this is also about career, work, abundance, the spiritual, whatever comes true. One thing for you is that you are going to be aware of a new talent that you have, or a new talent that will appear in your life, a new interest. New things are really being revealed to you in their fullness. And this is really going to bring you lots of fun and joy that will last throughout years and years and years. Your health and your job is something that's really going to be highlighted in December. You might have to open your home to a friend in need in this month as well. This friend could be coming from a far distance. This visit is really going to benefit you in many areas, but especially when it comes to your job and career area. Moving to a new place, city or country is something that you really could play around with in December. It's something that's really going to be heavily on your mind. It's something that you're going to like daydream about. It's something that you really want. And something is going to be presented to you around that area, and it's something that's going to tempt you. It really looks like your dreams are about to become a reality, Aquarius. Another thing is that doubts and insecurities might be something that's going to bother you in December. But you are going to be keeping this to yourself. You are sometimes very good at keeping things to yourself. But an older person could really be helping you with sorting some of those things out in your life. Also for you, I am going to give you a song that's going to be your theme song for December. I will put it on the screen, and I am also going to put a link in the description box. So it is your song for December. Pay attention to the song, the lyrics, the music video, if you can find that, whatever, you know, feelings that you get from the song, there might be hidden messages. So let's get into the reading. I am going to take one energy card from this deck. It really wants to focus on the magical stars in the background. But yeah, and then I'm going to take two energy cards from another deck. But really, again, be aware of things this month. Be aware of the unseen. One card. Ah, serendipity. Luck is coming your way. Let luck carry you. Opportunities are really going to come for you this month, and it fits perfectly together with what we spoke about with the friend that is going to benefit you, the older person that might come into your life. Just again, a lot of hidden opportunities. There is a lot of synchronicities and a lot of awareness around you this month. Transformation and full moon, again the unseen. The universe is really giving you signs. It's making you more aware of things that you want. It is also 18, so 9 being the almost fulfillment. So pay attention. Wow, grounded. You will become more grounded. Maybe even feel more grounded with someone special. We also have gratitude. Some of you guys might be dealing with a Libra, because that Libra had the gratitude and the thankfulness. I do believe it was Libra. But you are going to have this feeling of being more grounded in your life, and it is going to manifest into something new. But it is also, with this card, it is very important to be grateful for what you already have. Because if you're not grateful for what you already have, the new can come into your life. So again, be grateful. And you can make lists in the morning. That's something that I always do, where you are where you write down what you are grateful for. And it can be everything. It can be everything from being grateful for the cup of coffee, for the weather, for your eyesight, that you have a roof over your head. You can also be grateful for something that you want to happen, something that's not still there. I always do the thing where I manifest that way, where I say I'm grateful for the unexpected and the expected money coming into my life. And I always have unexpected money coming into my life from different sources, from different people, different ways. So again, believe in the unexpected. But let's see. Again, remember, it's not only about love. So I am doing the spread where it's you and it's another person, but it can also just be the energy or the situation that you are in. So first of all, let's see what is your card. Give us a card for you. I am just seeing if this is something. Okay. Some of you guys are having a hard time closing down for some old chapter. Maybe some of you guys are having a hard time letting go of a Scorpio. That can be. This is the card being single and awesome, living in prosperity, a lot of success. So some of you guys, you know, you might have a hard time let go of the mentalness. Also, like the insecurities that we had in the beginning of the reading. Like the insecurities are really trapping you from the new beginning here. You might be single or you might want to be single. This can also just be that you have a lot of success. This can have a lot of meanings. Let's see, what is the card for the other person or for the situation? Too many cards. But I did see the Emperor. So some of you guys might be dealing with the Aries. But the Ace of Swords. That is also the Yes card. This can be like a yes, you can do whatever you want. You have the, you know, you know the truth, you know how to get there. You know that this might involve you digging into old wounds, old pain, finally going through the lessons that you have ignored. But this can also be the other person in your life who might also be a sign, who's like, yes, I am finally manifesting what it is that I want. I am choosing one person. I am, again, it can also be you choosing someone else. Maybe you are really trapped into relationships and you want to become free so that you can choose someone else. Again, it can also be flipped. It can be the other person. But whatever this is the truth. This is really going after the truth. Let's see, what is this relationship situation about? Yeah. The universe is trying to offer you something you have manifested. And especially together with this is like, you better go after what it is that you are trying to manifest, because the universe is trying to give it to you all the time. But you might have these insecurities. If you are someone who's interested in someone else, you might be a little afraid that that person doesn't want you, because it might be a very powerful person. But the universe is really trying to offer you opportunities all the time. Like, you could do this, you can, you know, send this person a message, or this can be the other person always trying to, you know, being like, hello, I'm actually interested in you. At the bottom of the deck, we do have the Six of Cups. I do feel that it could be someone who is as social as you are. It might be someone that you're going to meet at some kind of event or something. Or you might invite them out, or they might invite you out. It might also just be the universe being like, don't be so shy anymore. Go out there, have fun. Let's see, how do you see this relationship? How do you see this relationship? Again, I do need to take it, because the Emperor just really wants to come true. for some reason, I do feel that you really want to go get it. You want to. You want to become this strong person. You want to show the other person that you are strong. But you are also hesitant because you know that it does mean that you need to go through a heartbreak. Just insecurities and heartbreak is something that's, you know, in the back of your mind all the time. This can also be how you see the other person. Like, you see the other person like two-faced, like, you might see the other person like someone who told you, like, they have a lot of passion for you, but when it comes to it, they are, you know, they are always healing, or there's always, like, insecurities, or there's always, like, excuses to, like, why? I don't know why I feel that there's, like, there's a lot of flirting, but not any action. But again, this could also be you, like, you're flirting with your dreams and desires, like, what it is that you want, but you don't really take action. It's like, you feel strong, you really do want to do it, but you don't feel that you can. Now that we have the Emperor, something had happened in the Aries season, where you're going to be like, all right, I am done, I am healed. Might still have some insecurities, but you're going to be full speed forward with whatever you want. Let's see, again, the roles can also be switched in the readings. How does the other person see this relationship? Whoa. The other person feels very quiet, but the other person is stalking you. But it's cute because both of you are actually, like, interested, but there's a lot of stalking, but no talking. There's a little talking, but not any serious talk. This can also, again, this can also just be you, or it can be the universe trying to, you know, be like, hey, go out there. Always sneaking things in your life to, you know, push you. Again, remember these cards. The universe is trying to offer you a cup of opportunity, a cup of love, whatever it is that you want. But you do need to go get it. It's like the ingredients that you need to manifest what it is that you want. Let's see what is the message from your higher self. What do you say? Yeah, you do need to be the fool and go get it. Whatever it is that you want, the universe is being like, well, if you don't do it, nothing is going to happen. The universe is pushing you. The universe is the little dog trying to push you off the cliff. It's like, yes, this is scary, but you are not going to fall. I lost my shoe. Let's see, what is the message from the other person's higher self? The world. I mean, hello. The universe is opening up a portal right now, where both of you, you know, the world, the universe is looking over to the fool being like, are you ready? Are you ready to take the steps? And the fool is going to be a little bit like, I don't know if I'm ready for this. But the fool is doing it. That means you are doing this at some point. Let's take a card for the unseen for you. What is it that you don't see here? Why do we always have so many cards? That is too many cards. But I did see the Justice card, so could be dealing with a Libra. One card, well, I will take it if it's necessary. Now that we have the Five of Wands reversed, for some reason, I don't know if you feel that the other person is looking for a fight, or the other person is always trying to compromise, always trying to push you away. It feels that way, like you don't see what you actually see here. I am going to take one more card. Why is it that we have the reverse Five of Wands? What is it that you don't see? Yeah, it's actually, it's like you don't see what it is that you see. Like this other person might make you very insecure, or you might see the other person as someone who's like always making jokes, always being like arrogant, or always trying to steer stuff up, like pinching at you. They are, I don't know if it's someone who's making jokes all the time, and you are a little like, what? But in real, it's actually like a cute thing. It's like what you learn in the school. We learned that in the Danish school, that if people make, you know, if people tease you in school, it's because that they like you. It has that kind of energy. Let's see, what is it that you don't see about the other person? What is it that you don't see? Woohoo! You don't see that they are actually feeling the same way. You are their wish fulfillment. They are just waiting for you to they're waiting for you to offer the cup. Someone is waiting here. Someone is waiting for, you know, for you to loosen up a little bit, or to come in their direction. But you might really be the one who's in a relationship here. If it's not a person, again, it's the universe trying to make you realize that you can actually go in the direction of what it is that you want. There's no one holding you back than your old, your own fight. Let's see, what is your purpose at the moment? I already have one. Win or lose. It's the same like we always have. This is a win or lose. It's like, either way, you're going to come out of your comfort zone here. You need to learn how to do that. This being blue, it's also sword, so you have a lot of mental conflicts with yourself. Again, five is new beginnings, and you do have a lot of fives here. Let's see, what is the other person's purpose? Shine. They are shining up. This is also number 10. So the other person, I do feel the other person is more like aware of what's going on. It's like they know that you guys like each other, but the other person wants you to make the move. Let's take the last card and see how can this move forward. Listen, change your focus. Again, green being emotion, you do need to listen to your emotions and really go after this. Change your focus from, you know, how you think about this now. And listen, because there is a lot of synchronicities, there's a lot of hidden things in this. Before my camera dies, I am going to sign off and say, this is all for you. I hope you guys could use the monthly message. I hope you could use the message for December. I hope you guys are going to have an amazing December. Remember to let me know if this resonated. Remember to like and subscribe if you haven't already. I would be more than grateful if you want to be a part of this magical family. But I will sign off now, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!